add to that, that arguably, if you're a little bit sharper, you're probably not going to make a mistake as easily. You're not going to make a wrong decision or step in the wrong place or stick your hand in the wrong place, that type of thing. Okay, guys. We're back here in a little pocket. This is a part that did not burn back when we had the old burn. We've got large saguaros, large ocotillos. Very large ocotillos. So I'm going to have to start being pretty quiet here if we have any chance of seeing game tonight. Or predators. You can see I do have my binoculars on me tonight. These are my Swarovski 10x42 ELs. It's an outstanding pair of optics. You guys may know by now that I'm kind of an optical nut. I'm really into optics, scopes, binoculars, that type of thing. And just a couple of points of carry tonight. When you're carrying your binoculars around your chest, make sure that your eyepieces are covered. You can see I have my eyepiece set right on top. As you're moving through the bush, you're going to have debris, dust, all kinds of other material. If it's raining or misty, you'll have to deal with that. So keeping these covered all the time is important. Now, this pair of binoculars does have objective covers that flip off fairly rapidly and hang from the front. Now, although covers help to keep your objective lenses in relatively pristine condition, they're not as vitally important as eyepiece covers. A small amount of dust on the eyepiece or the point where the exit pupil comes out of the ocular piece of the lens. A small amount of dust on the ocular piece or raindrop or moisture or something like that. Binocular people know, optics people know, that greatly reduces the image quality that the eye sees. That will distort it, it'll make it fuzzy, it'll make it dark very badly. Now on the other side, you can get a little dust or even some moisture on the objective and it doesn't make as much of a difference. Now, just a point, if you are carrying your binoculars in this fashion outside and not in a case, if you're transporting them, you're walking with them through the bush this way, just be aware that some branches and stuff like that it's possible to scratch that objective facing down, even against your own equipment. If you're wearing equipment, cover it up with, your clothing so that you're not jabbing it into a belt or something like that. So, protect your optics. I told you I'd show you some tracks if we came across them. We've got this is in the pocket that I described earlier. You can see there's a lot more vegetation here. And these tracks move from south to north, as I described earlier. And moving through this area, we have a fairly large buck mule deer. And that's a very good size print. I put my hand next there. Hopefully I'm in frame. But that's a good size print. That's the back hoof on a medium to heavy mule deer. Just a point about the deer out here. This area is predominantly mule deer, the larger the species that we have. And although we have some excellent deer populations, population density at the higher altitudes up in the northern parts of Arizona and the mountain areas, some of the biggest mule deer I've ever seen in my life are right here in this type of terrain. They like these ravine flats bordered by mountain foothills. They can wander around out here all day without being seen. So, you know, if a large animal like that, you know, 200-pound mule deer can run around out here, survive and thrive, then you know that a person with the right skill set can also do the same. Speaking of that, if you guys get a chance, head over to ArizonaBushman.com. Here's a few additional tracks coming up from the ravine. And this deer has made its way straight down this little area. So we're going to come over the top here and see what we can see. Okay, found a great little treat here near our deer tracks. This is going to be last year's drop. This is an antler drop. Just a little guy. Just wanted to show this guys to you. Show this to you guys. Just a great little shed antler here. Pretty polished up. It's about 1 year old. It's from last year. They typically drop their antlers out here around around April or so, mid to late April. So, got an interesting little hook up here at the end. Anyhow, nice little treat. I'm pretty excited to have found that. Always nice. I keep my eyes open for it, but this is a nice game pocket in here, and I'll be out in this area in late April this year. See if I can find some more. Just wanted to show you guys the houses over there really quick with the sun bouncing off of those windows. That golden flare out there that can be seen for so far. So if anyone doubts the old survival mirror, obviously those windows are a lot bigger, but the principle is the same. I'm trying to be a little bit more quiet now, but I did want to show you guys this barrel cactus. It's huge. That is a very big barrel cactus. Okay guys, I'm on the edge of a bowl here, and I'm overlooking good amount of terrain out to about 200 yards to the next rim or edge of the bowl. And so I'm just going to park here a little while. The sun's down. It's a lot darker than it appears on camera. So I'm just going to sit here and watch for movement. I'm going to sit here in glass. I'm going to take a seat, chill out for a bit. Getting back to my point about clothing, when I came out here I had to kind of make a compromise what I was going to wear. You don't want to alarm the locals, the residents. And a guy walking in full camo with a tripod, which could be mistaken for a firearm, could draw some attention. So, again, we live in a pretty sheepish world, and everything's scary to everybody these days. So, when you're doing these little suburban walks, keep in mind that you might have to dress for the occasion. Now, in that selection, I tried to pick colors that were reasonably, that would blend in reasonably well. Browns, greens, khakis, so without being camouflaged and looking scary, I can come out here and blend reasonably well. Okay guys, this mostly turned out to be a hike and talk tonight, but just some of the things that go through my head when I'm out hiking. And I'm gonna wait till it gets dark. I'm just gonna continue glassing, see if I can see some animals. And then we're gonna hike out tonight. I brought my 24-watt HID boxer for bullfights. You've seen that before in other videos, but anyhow, it should make for a nice hike out. I've got my safety glasses, so I'm not gonna get hooked in the eye while I'm moving back north tonight. So anyhow, thanks for watching, and I'll try to get out and do some more.